Prakash, to begin with the session.
Okay, good evening to all of you. And I would like to first thank Dr. Usha George, Principal, Dr. Fatima Vasant, Academic Director, Rex Johnson, Rex Dhanaval, Director and Secretary, Professor Mahalakshmi, and Professor Raja, who gave a nice introduction. I thank the management and the staff of Patrician College to give a opportunity to us to speak about a very current topic, supply chain management, and how it has changed our lives and how the COVID is going to give a paradigm shift to the entire way we look at supply chain. Next slide. So this is my background. So I have been with shipping lines most of the time, and I have been with domestic logistics and also freight forwarding companies. So this is my experience from 1990. I have been working till 2017. And 2017, I took the a new venture to teach people about logistics. Next slide. So let's straight go into the subject. So what is supply chain management? Supply chain management is a word that's been used widely. So in order to provoke your thoughts and to make you understand, I want to show you a picture of how things go into making a car. Now, if I ask you all a question, how many spare parts go to make a car? Is there anyone to answer? Any size of car, maybe a Swift car or could be a BMW 7 Series, or does anyone have idea of how many spare parts go to make a car?
40,000.
Yes, exactly. It is about 1,800 for a small size car, up to a 30 to 35,000 spares. That's a good answer. I mean, a round of applause to you who has said that. So about 18,800 spare parts to 40,000 spare parts go into making a car. Imagine all these spares are made by different suppliers. We call them tier one suppliers or tier two suppliers or tier three suppliers. Now, all of this have to come to a factory, and the factory has to set up the assembly line. Now, the setting up the assembly line itself is a big subject. Then the cycle time to produce a car from the time you load the first spare part and then get the car out of the assembly line, and from the time a customer drives a car out. So this is the supply side. We call it upstream. Getting all the raw materials. To make a car, you need four seats. You need five tires, one steering wheel, and then you need six windshields. Imagine the number of spare parts that is going into it. Next slide, please. So when this car is driven out, a person called customer takes the car. Now, why is customer important is, the first thing you must understand in the supply chain, the customer has to be satisfied, and he is the one who says how much of demand he is going to make to the manufacturer. So that's called the demand forecast. I try to look for definition from Philip Kotler and all the management and marketing gurus, but I found Mahatma Gandhi gave the best definition of the customer. He says he's a visitor. Look at the yellow arrow. He says the most important visitor could be to a showroom of a car, could be into your website, could be into your online portal. So whether he's virtually visiting or whether he's physically coming, he's the most important visitor. We are existing because of him. And look at the second arrow. He's the purpose of it. Okay. The third arrow says he's not an outsider, he's an insider. Like he's part of the business. The fourth arrow says he's part of it. So if you take all these four yellow arrows and compare it to a supply chain, now he is going to be part of the supply chain because he is going to tell you the information of how much demand he is going to make so that you collect so much of spare parts to make a product for him. So he is the most important. So let us go into what is logistics and what is supply chain. There has been a two definitions. So let us define both of it. Next slide. Logistics is a flow of material from supplier into an organization, within the organization, and to the customer. It is a supply system, includes the process, planning, controlling, efficient, effective flow, and storage of goods. What this definition logistics does not touch is, it does not touch about a customer. It touches about flow of material. It doesn't touch about customer. Next slide. Next slide, please. So the material flow, no, you've gone to the next, the previous slide. So logistics concerns about moving tangible materials and information which is intangible. So it only concerns about material which is tangible and information flow. It doesn't talk about customer here. Now look at role of logistics in this slide. On the right extreme top, you have external supplier. On the left extreme, you have customer. So the materials move in from the inbound logistics, gets manufactured inside a big square box like a car, and then goes to a customer. So inbound logistics of raw material, there is a processing happening just above the diagram of the car. There's a big rectangle, and then it goes out. Okay, so that is role of logistics. So just to put it in a very simple way, it is physical movement of materials. Can you come to the next slide? Yeah, it is physical movement of materials from one point to another, which includes warehousing, distribution, fleet management, and information flow. Next slide. Supply chain, let us now start discussing about that. It was a word that was coined in 1900, okay, where it was a military word borrowed from military, where it describes about getting food, weapons, ammunition, arms to the front line which is fighting the battle. There is a contact point or a supply point between the military base and the frontline battlefield. So supply chain originated from the word military. Now let's look at supply chain management definition. Supply chain consists of activities and materials that organizations move through the journey from initial supplier to final customer. If you notice the difference, there is a customer who has featured in the definition of supply chain. Goods and services flow from supplier to producer, even services are included, to a customer's final user. Supply chain management is concerned with interfaces between organizations. In logistics, it is only concerned about flow of goods and flow of information. Here, it is linking two organizations. It is a network of manufacturers, supplier of raw materials, and suppliers on the one hand, which is called the upstream, and on the downstream, we call customer and customer's customer. As you go through some pictures, visuals, you'll be able to get clarity on this. So supply chain definition touches about customer and why it is important to move raw material to a factory and from the factory as a final out product to the customer. Okay. Now, there's a new word called transportation. Why I'm going through the definition of supply chain is people confuse between logistics, the word transportation, the word supply chain. Okay. So transportation, the words are the modes of transport. It can go by sea, it can go by air, it can go by rail or road. So that is the only simple definition of transportation. Now, if you need to take a simple definition now to create supply chain, it is logistics plus procurement of raw materials from the tier one, tier two suppliers, plus connecting the transportation modes of transport. Then we look at customer who is giving us the demand forecast. Why is demand forecast important? Because he is the primary important part of the supply chain as told by Mahatma Gandhi. Then the suppliers, the vendors we call them, who supply raw materials. And finally, supply chain also includes stakeholders who are the shareholders or the owners of proprietary concern or the partnership partners of a partnership company, or if they are a private limited company, the shareholders and the stakeholders. So they need return on investment. So there's no point in doing all your supply chain and not having return on investment. So it's a multi-enterprise, which means more than one organization is connected to the supply chain. So if you look at this diagram, it says supplier, and then the white box says supplier. The focus company is the manufacturing, and the customer on the right side, and the end customer. Next slide, please. So if you have to look at an academic definition, supply chain is a set of approaches to efficiently integrate suppliers, manufacturers, warehouses. Warehouses are places where you store your raw materials and store so that merchandise is produced and distributed. So the new angle called distribution is coming in supply chain. Now, logistics was concerned about only movement of goods, flow of goods. Now, here we have distribution at the right quantity. Okay, underline the word right quantity to the right location and at the right time in right order to minimize wide cost, system-wide cost while satisfying service level requirements. Next slide, please. Next slide. So supply chain in totality is consisting of the overall business strategy. For a company, supply chain is not something, a separate entity. It is comprising of the company's vision, mission, goals, and then it converts the entire thing into transforming values from the company to the customer and the supplier supplying raw material to the company. Next slide, please. So what is supply chain management? We have taken another definition, the design and management of seamless value-added process across organizational boundaries to meet real need of end customer. This has been given by Institute of Supply Chain Management. And the Supply Chain Council also gives a beautiful definition. Managing supply and demand, sourcing raw material and parts, manufacturing and assembling, warehousing, inventory tracking, order entry, order management, distribution across all channels and delivery to the customer. This is one of the best definitions I have seen, but can you go to the previous slide? But what this definition has missed out, if you analyze, they have not touched about stakeholders, the return on investment. So that also the financial flow. We have three flows in the supply chain. One is the information flow, then the material flow, and then the last is the financial flow. So still, the definition of supply chain is still not clearly got out by some part of it we keep missing. So please understand, it needs flow of material, it needs to take care of the supplier, it needs to take care of the customer, and then the stakeholder. Unless you do all these things, supply chain is not going to be successful. Okay, next one. Next slide, please. So the logistics is part of or a component of supply chain management. And why I bring this data at this context, it's a $4 trillion business segment, 10% of the global GDP, which means it's a huge cost going into handling supply chain. And this industry calls for a lot of people requirement. Logistics is about people. The supply chain is about manufacturing and connected with people. So there is a lot of requirement of labor intensive industry. So there is requirement. So if manufacturing goes up, logistics will go up. Currently, why the logistics is down? Because manufacturing itself is down because of the COVID issue. So once the manufacturing picks up, economies pick up, again, there'll be requirement of people, and logistics could be a great industry for students like you to get employed. So that is why I bring this $4 trillion business slide in this context so that you understand how big this business, this industry is in today's context. Next slide, please. So supply chain, if you look at the right extreme of the slide, it says raw material supplier. There are some colorful boxes, right? Then two white boxes, intermediate component suppliers. And then in the middle, we have manufacturers, e-com companies, service. So these are all, you can have raw material coming in, or it could be e-com companies, or it could be a services industry like hospitals, hotels, travel and leisure. All of them need supply chain. So it comes to the middle, manufacturers, e-commerce or services, get the manufacturing or value addition. And it moves out of the manufacturer's factory to a wholesale distributor. So that's customer. Customer's customer is retailer. Then it goes to the end customer. So from right extreme, raw material supplier, it comes into a manufacturing point and then reaches out to. So this entire gamut is called supply chain. At the top of the slide, if you look, there is product and service flow, then the returns also sometimes happen. When you order something on Amazon, if it's defective, you return it, right? So that is also, that is called reverse logistics. So that is also part of the supply chain. And at the bottom arrow, if you look at it, there is information, planning, activity, integrating the entire supply chain. So this a visual can explain to you, as a few more visuals I have, so that it registers in your mind exactly what is supply chain. So first, we need to define supply chain. Okay, one more visuals I'm trying to show you. The center part of the slide where it says on top of it, if you look at it, it says in company. Okay, on the right, on the left side, if you see, it says suppliers, right? And on the left side, if you see, on the right side, if you see, there is customers. On the left side, you have suppliers. Now come to the bottom of the slide. If you look at the bottom of the slide, this was something like in the 1960s where we had only materials management. Okay? We didn't have something called logistics or supply chain, we just had materials management or a purchase department, head of purchase. We never had something called logistics department. So there only the physical flow of goods and materials were looked at. And if you look at the blue color box in the middle, it says physical flow plus information flow. This is in 1980s, 85s, 90s, we have logistics coming in as a value added thing more than the materials managed. And 2000 and 2010, 12, can you go? If you look at it, there are three flows. No, previous slide.